turn this over to Rhonda as far as what is being done in the community here with the University of Florida Health System, UF Health, which formerly known as Shands. Welcome.
Well, good afternoon. This is like a friendly crowd. I've been here so often. In fact, you tell me I should join. Right? Yeah, I know. I've got to say hi to Roger. Roger is another friend of our UF Health System. We do an awful lot of work with the airport with the staff at the airport. We provide a lot of health events for his organization. And we appreciate Roger and all the help he's given us. What I wanted to share with you just a few minutes before I invite Tony up here. Literally, you have seen probably the land has been pretty much excavated in regards to clear it out for the new medical center. We have literally formally broken ground. That part of the county, by the way, for your information, you probably already know this, is still one of the fastest growing areas within the Flat County area. There's another fast growing area that happens to be in Clay County that's expanding rapidly, but this area is growing very, very rapidly. The building is going to be somewhere around a 4 to 5 to 6 story building. It is going to be a mixture of UF physicians and specialties, but also community doctors will be part of the building. We will run an emergency department out there, an imaging center on the first floor. Urgent care will be on the first floor. So there'll be some basic services in regards to the needs from an emergency standpoint. It is not required of us to file for a CON, a certificate of need, based on the fact that we're building a medical office building. But we will literally be reapplying for our CON next month to the state of Florida. You may recall that last year when we filed, Memorial Health System, HCA, filed a challenge against our application. What we've done with the new application, for your information, is expanded it. We are now reaching out to other counties. We've moved the market area up to past Nassau County, actually in the St. Mary's in South Georgia. So we've expanded the marketplace in regards to the lives that we're covering. Let me turn the meeting over to what you're really here, and that's to listen to our preparedness. Tony, we go by first names in our organization. Tony is the Emergency Preparedness Director. I actually just got a first chance to know him just a few minutes ago. He's a very active part of our organization, as you will hear. We're doing some very unique things in emergency management. I think one of the things I'd like you to focus on is that he comes out primarily out of the emergency department, and we literally process about over 100,000 patients a year through the emergency department, so it's a very busy place. And he's in the midst of all that. He's going to come up and talk about our emergency preparedness. Come.
And I also want to thank Ron for the promotion I just received. I'm actually the coordinator for the management program, not the director. But I was delighted to see when I came in that you had a preparedness piece on your front page. That's just outstanding. Well, as Ron said, I am with UF Health, formerly known as Shands. I've been there 8 years as their emergency preparedness coordinator. And I will tell you that UF Health truly is a secret in this community. And hopefully as we go through this little presentation I put together, you might get a better idea of what we do and how far our fingers really reach into the community. How does UF Health fit into the community for preparedness? We reach out to just about any kind of group you can think about. We have partnerships with the military. Here's an example of the military training on our grounds. They actually set up a field hospital in one of our parking lots. This happens all the time. Helicopters out of Kings Bay and also out of N Jax will do touch and goes on our helipad to practice the fact that when they do need to come, they can easily touch down on our helipad. So we're very involved with military. We have an MOU with Kings Bay in particular, with the nuclear submarine base. Should a person working in the propulsion area, which is a very large part of the base, so I've been up there to tour it, suffer a traumatic event, fall off a ladder, have a stroke, have a heart attack, and the process of falling down, get some radiation on them, we have certain protocols. We're the only hospital in the city that has these protocols to deal with the people from Kings Bay. So there's a lot of opportunity for us to deal with a lot of different people. So we belong to the Mayor's Security Emergency Preparedness Planning Council. This brings the mayors of Jacksonville and the Beaches, the sheriff and the sheriff of the Beaches, CEOs and high directors of just about every single company. I know Haskell's there. I know JEA is there, JTA, you name an organization in town that probably employs more than 50 people, they're at this meeting. And it's quite impressive to see how far the city goes in planning the preparedness for any type of disaster. We are also part of the First Coast Disaster Council and past president of that. This is a group that meets monthly. We bring together every organization that could possibly work a disaster each month to sit at a table over lunch. Every hospital comes, Red Cross, Salvation Army, EMS workers, Sheriff's Office, Homeland Security. While we may compete on a daily basis, when it comes to a disaster, we realize we've got the community in our sights. And when I say disaster, I don't just mean a hurricane. We are considered a tier two city, Jacksonville is. Tier one would be New York, Chicago, LA. Jacksonville is a tier two for a couple of reasons. You've got 95 and 10 meeting, you've got the port, you have three military bases, and so we are fairly high on the list of potential targets as far as terrorism goes. So that's where they rank us as a tier two. We participate with the Emergency Operations Center of the city. I'm the liaison for our hospital to that group. The Regional Domestic Security Task Force is primarily law enforcement driven, but we sit on that as well too. We are considered critical infrastructure in our community, just like a nuclear power plant, a dam, or a bridge. And we're an active member of the Florida Hospital Association. And this year, I'm fortunate enough to represent Region 3, which is the 13 counties in Northeast Florida, on a state level, working on building healthcare coalitions. To steal a phrase from a prior administration, drill, baby, drill, it became very apparent when the events in Boston occurred that they were so well prepared because those hospitals drill constantly. And we also drill constantly in Jacksonville. We work with the airport very, very often. As a matter of fact, we had a meeting yesterday and a representative from the airport was there telling us about your upcoming drill next year, working on that. And we'll partner with you on that as well, too. We just, 4 months ago, did a radioactive explosive device at a tennis tournament. It dealt with radiation and bringing radiation patients into the hospital and have them decontaminated and treated. Bomb, burn, blast injuries. We do hurricane simulations. So we're constantly trying to figure out what is going to happen in this community. And now with active shooter being such a top, every other day it seems like there's an active shooter. We are practicing for active shooter as well too. Real life events. I put the Koran burning up in Gainesville as a really good example. You wouldn't think much about that. Well, it just so happened the day that particular person wanted to burn the Koran, there was a huge game in the swamp. So suddenly you had roughly 80,000 people in Gainesville. If this had happened, and if repercussions had occurred, we were on standby the entire day and evening to be a secondary receiving hospital. The hospital at NES Jax was also on alert to standby, as was Wolfson's and Baptist downtown. We took this very, very seriously, as we did with the Republican National Convention. We drilled for months for that. The shot that you see here is a C-130 cargo plane on the NAS Jax landing strip unloading patients from Hurricane Katrina. Patients were flown in, and they were triaged to various hospitals, and at the time, Shands, we received 13 patients from Hurricane Katrina. We were also receiving a hospital for the Haitian earthquake. There was a horrific accident on the Intercoastal Waterway a couple years back. We had 17 people injured by two parties drinking and being on the river. So things can change very, very quickly at our facility. We are the only level one trauma center in Northeast Florida and Southeast Georgia. And that means every type of physician that you're going to need, every discipline, we have there 24/7. We are not going to pick up a phone and call in a hand surgeon. The hand surgeon is there. The neurosurgeon is there. We are blessed with a good pediatric ER, but we are truly blessed by having a top surgeon in his field. He's nationally recognized for a pediatric trauma surgeon, Dr. Joseph Tipas. We have doctors and surgeons on our campus that are world-renowned for procedures they've come up with. Again, a hidden gem in our community. We are the facility when the President of the United States visits our area. If Air Force One is going to touch down anywhere in our area, Secret Service in our place 2-3 days before, we work it out. There's an agent that's in the building the entire time Air Force One is on the ground, and we have an operating room reserved for him at all times, and we have a negative pressure room reserved for him at all times. So we do a pretty good job. We have TraumaOne. I'm very, very proud of TraumaOne. We have 3 helicopters, one in Lake City, one in Yulee, and one down in St. Augustine. We decided instead of having one based at the hospital, we'd rather have 3 triangulating around the community for a faster response time. We go out as far as Suwanee and Putnam, Flagler into southeast Georgia, and we do this for on-scene response and critical transport. Now, the north side in particular, this presents some unique qualities for us. Obviously, JIA is here. There's still a lot of rural areas up here that are quickly turning urban in many ways, and there's rapid growth on the north side of the urban core. And so there is a lot of focus on the north side of town. So as Ron alluded to, our growth continues. Besides being the level 1 trauma center, we also on our campus have one of the proton beam therapy centers in the country. We have patients flying in from all over the world to take advantage of the proton beam therapy. And now we're building a freestanding ER and medical office complex on the north side. It'll be a one-stop healthcare destination offering primary and specialty care services. So as you can see, I think we're at a pretty strategic location. Extremely close to the airport, River City Mall, a lot of growth happening, and we're only 11 miles away from the trauma center. It's obviously very easy to get to, 295 and 9A, across the street from the marketplace. It's very close to JIA, and like I said, 11 miles to the hospital. So this is going to be a new state-of-the-art facility, and I don't use that term lightly. Every planning meeting I've been in, all I hear is, give us your entire wish list. Go as far as you want to go. We want to make this the leading facility in Jacksonville. So there's a lot of planning going on with this facility. Emergency management preparedness. As Ron alluded to, we will have physicians' offices. We will also have our ED and radiology down here, our surgery suite up here as well too. Because we have an emergency room here, we need a full decontamination team and decontamination processes. So that will be in place as well too, and it's being built right into the main building as we build it. Community partnerships. Everything we do with the community in mind. If we walked into the EOC downtown in the city right now and pulled any plan off their shelf, within the first 2 paragraphs, Shands-Jacksonville/UF Health would be mentioned. We are that vital to this community. We are in every single plan. We work closely with Jacksonville Fire Rescue, Emergency Medical Services. We outreach to counties north, west, south of us. We drill with other hospitals in our delivery area. We drill with the military, including Kings Bay. And we drill every time we can with JIA. And I've got to say, it's a thrill to actually be on the runway when a plane is taking off close by. It's quite a thrill. We are a Joint Commission accredited institution. We are part of the University of Florida and Gator Nation. I'm embarrassed. I did not know, coming from New York and New Jersey, how big college football was in the South. So on one of my first trips down here, as I decided to drive down and see the country a little bit, I crossed the border. I started seeing these signs for FLAGA. I'm like, what's a FLAGA? Yeah. FLAGA. Well, it was Florida Georgia weekend. And I soon learned what FLAGA was, and I soon learned what Gator Nation was. So I've been well schooled in that. We have received the Governor Sterling Award twice for national performance excellence. We've recently received magnet recognition for nursing excellence. Just this past year, the University Hospital Association, it ranks hospitals that are similar to ourselves. So we're being compared to hospitals that are level one trauma centers with about 700 beds. And we moved from the year before, a ranking of number 44, jumped up to the number 19. And that's tremendous growth for us. We're very, very proud of that. We've got a primary stroke center, and we are nationally recognized for our stroke center. And we also have the Blue Distinction Award for knee and hip replacement surgery. This down here actually is our roots. We were founded actually in 1870 as Florida's first non-military hospital, and it sure looks primitive compared to what we have today. Before I close out, I just want to let you know, I truly am a success story with our facility. 3 years ago, I felt short of breath. Didn't feel right. Went to my ED, they checked me in, and discovered I had heart failure. And within days, I was having open heart surgery. So I had 4 bypasses, a valve repair. I was in on a Tuesday morning. I was home the following Monday. I was swimming in the ocean off Fernandina Beach 6 weeks later. 3 years later, I have a whole new life. The surgeons there truly are amazing. I owe my life to this institution, and I'm so proud to work for them. So on behalf of University of Florida Health in Jacksonville and TraumaOne, I want to thank you for your support in the city, our surrounding counties, and what you do on a daily basis. Together as a community, we're all partners when it comes to disaster, either natural or man-made. Remember, every disaster is local. No matter how big or small, it's local. The best defense is to have a go and be prepared defense, so be prepared. And just very quickly, this is my team. Chad McIntyre runs our flight services, huge task that he is tasked with. Rebecca Goldenberg is new to our team, trauma and educator. We believe the more prevention we can do, the less people we can keep at the trauma center. We do believe heavily in prevention. So on that note, I want to say thank you very much for your time, and thank you for the invite. I really appreciate it. Have a great day.